invite you to please stand as you are able. Let us join our voices together, our opening hymn, Wash, O God, Our Sons and Daughters. Let's sing together.
Divine, to the world so freely given, agent of God's grand design, peace on earth and joy in heaven. Christ our Lord, to you we raise this our hymn.
Thank you, my friends. Please be seated. Well, good morning, St. Andrew by the Sea. Welcome to worship on this beautiful Lord's Day, this Confirmation Sunday. So happy to have all of you joining with us in worship today, those of you here in person at our 10 a.m. service, along with those who are worshiping with us online right now, along with those who might be coming at 11:09 today, who may not have gotten the memo. All of you today are part of the St. Andrew by the Sea family, and we welcome you today with grace and with hospitality. My name is Jonathan Tompkins, one of the pastors here, along with Pastor Frank Librand, and we welcome you and pray that you have a blessed and meaningful worship experience with us here today. I would like to invite you here in the pews, if you would please begin passing the attendance pads. Please mark down that you're here. If you're joining us today for the first time, we welcome you as our guest, and we pray that you have a wonderful opportunity to worship alongside of our family. If you are with us for the first time, if you just indicate that in the attendance pad, we will just contact you later this week with more information about us. You will see that there is an insert in your bulletin with all kinds of announcements on it. I want to invite you to take that home with you and find ways this week that you can connect with us here at St. Andrew. I do just want to lift up two things today. The first, you'll see an announcement about our tech team. We want to thank our tech team, and we also want to encourage you to be part of our tech team. We've had a core team of volunteers who, for the past 4 or 5 years now, have been dedicating countless hours, volunteer hours, to helping our technology, our AV needs here at St. Andrew-by-the-Sea. Our core team of Bob Gensler, Jeff Bornhauser, David Peterson, Jim Phillips, Bobby Riggs, and Carrie Tilden have really worked hard to make worship a multi-sensory experience. So can we please just give them our thanks for all their efforts? Now, they could use some reinforcements. We are looking for some more people to join our tech team. We do have some good news. We have hired an AV coordinator. His name is Brian Dobbs, and Brian is back in the booth today as well, and we are thrilled that he has joined our staff. And we're looking for more great people to be on the team. So you'll see the announcement there. There are two ways that you can help. You can be part of the screen team, and that involves pretty much sitting in your pew and tapping on an iPad while you are following along in the worship service. You do have to follow along in the worship service, but you can tap on an iPad to do that. And then also, if you can help control the volume, control the sound during the service, and ultimately we're going to get to hopefully where we can do that from an iPad as well. But please contact Bob Gensler if you are willing to support this vital, vital ministry of St. Andrew-by-the-Sea. Also, you will see today that we are having communion. A reminder that here in the United Methodist Church, we practice an open communion table. That means you do not have to be a member of St. Andrew-by-the-Sea. You do not have to be United Methodist to participate in communion today. All you have to be is willing to receive the good gifts of God that we feel are represented to us by the bread and by the cup. When you come forward, we will have three stations today. You'll be directed to come forward to one of those stations. We ask that you come forward with your hands out, and a piece of bread will be placed into your hand, and then you take that bread and you dip it into the cup and partake of the elements together. We use King's Hawaiian sweet bread for our communion. We use Welch's 100% grape juice for our communion. We believe that you should taste and see how good God is, and that's the way that we do that with communion. However, we know that some of you need some gluten-free options, and so we have a gluten-free bread option available for you as well. Please just let your server know if you require the gluten-free option. For those of you online, we welcome you as well to this communion table. Although you can't be here physically, you are part of us worshiping today, and so if you have access to bread and juice of some sort, please partake in communion along with us during that time. Friends, we are so grateful you have joined with us on this special, special Confirmation Sunday. We continue with our worship now. Our beautiful chancel choir has a beautiful hymn, The Summons. We will also take our offering during this time, and so we thank you for your continued generosity in giving to the mission and ministry of St. Andrew-by-the-Sea through your gifts and through your offerings. I'll call the ushers to come forward now. For the last 2 months, 18 of our young people have been exploring what it means to be a United Methodist, along with the help of many of our adult mentors up from our church here. And they are now ready to make their commitment to become full members of St. Andrew-by-the-Sea United Methodist Church. I would like to invite our confirmants to please come and take their places at the altar rail. Congregation, if you would please find a hymnal in your pew and please open to page 33. Brothers and sisters in Christ, through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We are incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through water and the Spirit. All this is God's gift offered to us without price.
Through confirmation and through the reaffirmation of our faith, we renew the covenant declared at our baptism, acknowledge what God is doing for us, and affirm our commitment to Christ's holy church.
To my confirmand friends, we have these questions for you. On behalf of the whole church, we ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin?
Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they may take?
Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord in union with the church, which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races?
According to the grace given to you, will you remain faithful members of Christ's holy church and serve as Christ's representatives in the world?
And now to you, church. Do you, as Christ's body, the church, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ?
We do.
Will you nurture one another in the Christian faith and life and include these young persons now before you in your care? With God's help, we will proclaim the good news and live according to the example of Christ. We will surround these persons with a community of love and forgiveness, that they may grow in their trust of God and be found faithful in their service to others. We will pray for them, that they may be true disciples who walk in the way that leads to life.
Let us join together in professing the Christian faith as contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testament. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ?
I believe in Jesus Christ,
his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and was buried. He ascended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church,
the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Eternal Father, when nothing existed but chaos, you swept across the dark waters and brought forth light. In the days of Noah, you saved those on the ark through water.
After the flood, you set in the clouds a rainbow. When you saw your people as slaves in Egypt, you led them to freedom through the sea. Their children you brought through the Jordan to the land which you promised.
Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Tell of God's mercy each day.
In the fullness of time, you sent Jesus, nurtured in the water of a womb. He was baptized by John and anointed by your Spirit. He called his disciples to share in the baptism of his death and resurrection and to make disciples of all nations.
Declare his works to the nations, his glory among all people.
Pour out your Holy Spirit to bless this gift of water and those who receive it, to wash away their sin and clothe them in righteousness throughout their lives, that dying and being raised with Christ, they may share in his final victory. All praise to you, eternal Father, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns forever. Amen.
Confirmands, if you would please kneel. And Fisher Baroni, if you would please come to the font along with your immediate family and your mentor. Fisher, touch the water and remember your baptism and be thankful. Fisher Lane, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to sing, Fisher, Fisher, God Claims You.
Fisher, fish.
Mia Clark. Mia Watson, we baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And may the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's sing.
Mia, Mia, God claims you. God.
Lila Gurrell. Lila, touch the water and remember your baptism and be thankful. Lila, the grace, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's sing.
Lila, Lila.
Trip Jeffords. All right, Trip, touch the water and remember your baptism and be thankful. I'm going to use your full name here just this one time, okay? All right. Evander Gilbert III, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Let's sing. Trip, trip.
Trip, trip.
Elsie Clar. Come a little closer. Elsie Elizabeth, we baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Let's sing.
Elsie.
Kyle Larson. Kyle, touch the water and remember your baptism and be thankful. Kyle Joseph, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Let's sing.
Kyle.
Walker Newman. Walker, touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. Walker Philip, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's sing.
Walker.
Caitlin Nicole. Caitlin, touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. Caitlin Rose, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Let's sing. Trip Nickel. Trip, touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. William Robert III, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's sing. Trip, trip. Trip. Ella Olivetti. Ella, touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. Ella Kai, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Let's sing. Ella, J.B. Peck. J.B., touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. Jack Brooker, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's sing J.B., J.B. J.B. Caroline Risher. Caroline, touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. Caroline Reese, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's sing. Caroline, Caroline. All right, touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. Merritt Stone, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's sing together. Caroline Sundling. Caroline, touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. Caroline Margaret, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's sing. Caroline. Sydney Tilton. Sydney, touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. Sydney Reese, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's sing. Edward Tompkins. Edward, touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. Edward Douglas, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's sing. And Mary Elizabeth Tompkins. Mary Elizabeth, touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. Mary Elizabeth,
the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. West Wilkins. West, touch the water, remember your baptism, and be thankful. West Thornton, the Holy Spirit work within you, that having been born through water and the Spirit, you may live as a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's sing. I would like our new members to please stand. I have two more questions for you. As members of Christ Universal Church, will you be loyal to the United Methodist Church and do all in your power to strengthen its ministries?
As members of this congregation, will you faithfully participate in its ministries by your prayers, your presence, your gifts, service, and your witness?
I will.
Members of the household of God, I commend these young persons to your love and care. Do all in your power to increase their faith, confirm their hope, and perfect them in love. Please join me. We give thanks for all that God has already given you, and we welcome you in Christian love as members together with you in the body of Christ and in this congregation of the United Methodist Church. We renew our covenant faithfully to participate in the ministries of the church by our prayers, our presence, our gifts, and our service, that in everything God may be glorified through Jesus Christ. New members, if you would please turn and face your congregation. Congregation, you will see that each of them has a stole on. These were made by them. And you'll see that there are various words on them. There are Bible scripture references. There are images. These are all things that represent to our young people who God is to them, who Jesus Christ is to them, how the Holy Spirit is working in their lives. I want to encourage you after the service today at our lunch. Young people, I'm going to ask that you keep your stoles on even at lunchtime, okay? And I'm going to ask the congregation if you would come and approach them and just kind of take a look and maybe ask a question or two about what it is on their stole and what is meaningful to them on that. All right, young people, we've got some more work to do now. Okay? Take your certificates. Those are your confirmation certificates with your names in them. Please take them, put them in your confirmation Bible, and you're going to want to hold on to those. Please return to your seats with the exception of our scripture readers. Scripture readers, please come, grab your Bibles, and lead us in our scripture reading.
Our first scripture today is from 1 Samuel 3. Now the boy Samuel was serving the Lord under Eli. Eli, the Lord's word was rare at the time, and visions weren't widely known. One day Eli, whose eyes had grown so weak he was unable to see, was lying down in his room. God's lamp hadn't gone out yet, and Samuel was lying down in the Lord's temple where God's chest was. The Lord called to Samuel. "I'm here," he said. Samuel hurried to Eli and said, "I'm here. You called me." "I didn't call you," Eli replied. "Go lie down." So he did. Again, the Lord called Samuel. So Samuel got up, went to Eli, and said, "I'm here. You called me." "I didn't call you, my son," Eli replied. "Go lie down." Now Samuel didn't yet know the Lord, and the Lord's word hadn't yet been revealed to him. A third time, the Lord called Samuel. He got up, went to Eli, and said, "I'm here. You called me." Then Eli realized that it was the Lord who was calling the boy. So Eli said to Samuel, "Go and lie down. If he calls you, you say, 'Speak, Lord, your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down where he'd been. Then the Lord came and stood there, calling just as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel said, "Speak, your servant is listening." The Lord said to Samuel, "I'm about to do something in Israel that will make the ears of all who hear it tingle."
Matthew chapter 22. "Teacher, what is the greatest commandment in the law?" He replied, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your being, and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. The second is like it. You must love your neighbor as you love yourself. All the law and prophets depend on these two commandments."
The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Since February, our confirmands have been making connections. The curriculum for our confirmation class is called Connections. And so we have been connecting with self, with God, with church, with neighbor, with heritage, and with creation. Our young people have been learning more about what it means to be a United Methodist, what it means to love God with everything we've got, and to love our neighbor as we love ourselves by supporting our church with our confirmands. We just promised to do this. It's the thing that's written on the hand that's on the back of your stole. Okay, say it again with me. With our prayers, presence, gifts, service, and witness. All right. Congregation, if I quizzed you on that right now, would you have been able to answer as good as them? Confirmands, keep on connecting. We have been stressing to you that confirmation is not graduation, right? You haven't graduated from the church now. This is just another step on your discipleship journey. I want to encourage you to keep connecting. Connect with God through your church. Be a Samuel. Samuel, who was a young person, who a beautiful prayer that you could always pray, young people, is, "Speak, Lord, your servant is listening." In the story of Samuel, God spoke to a young person, "Speak, Lord, your servant is listening." That's an appropriate prayer for all of us. But young people, be a Samuel. Find yourself an Eli. You've got several Elis already, the mentors that have been working with us all throughout confirmation. They are your Elis. Pastor Frank, me, Miss Connie, we are your Elis. We are the older folks who can help you hear what God might be saying to you. Be a Samuel, find an Eli. Love God. Love God with everything you've got. Love God with your prayers, your presence, your gifts, your service, and your faithful witness. Be present. Be here. We love having you here. Church, do we love having them here? Be present. I was so impressed with your faithfulness to coming to confirmation for 2 months straight. Y'all's attendance was amazing. Keep on doing that. Now that we don't have confirmation, we still have ways for you to gather. We've got Sunday school. We've got a wonderful youth Sunday school. Come for the donuts. Stay for the Jesus, all right? It's a wonderful time to get together. Parents, you've got a great Sunday school opportunity as well. Drop your kids off for donuts and you get to go next door to Starbucks and get coffee. Java with Jesus, Sunday school class for parents starting up. Coffee and Jesus, two wonderful things. Young people, we've got youth group opportunities, lots of ways for us to get together. Be present. Use your gifts. Use your gifts in worship, your God-given talents. You've already done it today. You've been reading scripture. You're serving communion. You're ushering. Keep on doing that. It doesn't have to be just one Sunday, a special Sunday. Any Sunday is a Sunday where you can use your gifts in worship. Play some music. Sing. Do all kinds of things with us in worship. Pray. Pray for us. We adults, we need your prayers. Pray for your church. Pray for the needs of our community. We need your prayers. Love God with everything you've got. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. How awesome was that service project that we did, making 160 cookie kits for folks to make together as a family over spring break? Y'all did a wonderful job. We knocked that thing out in what, like 45 minutes? That was amazing what we can do when we all do it together. Keep doing things like that. This church is wonderful when it comes to service and mission opportunities. The adults want you to participate in those things along with them. Keep being a faithful witness to the love, grace, and mercy of Jesus Christ in this world. Church, here's the thing is, did you notice in the liturgy, you just reaffirmed your commitment to all of these things as well. Did you pick up on that? You just reaffirmed your commitment. Connect. Connect with these confirmands. Connect. Be an Eli. Help our young people to love God and love neighbor. Do it along with them. The best example is your life example. Be an Eli to these young people. Love alike, even when we think or look or act differently, even if we're different generations, we can still, like John Wesley said, we can still love alike, and we can do it together. As God said to Samuel, I'm about to do something at St. Andrew that's going to make the ears of all who hear it tingle. My ears are tingling already. Thanks be to God. Caitlin, please come and lead us in our prayer of the people. You'll find it in your bulletin, and your part is in bold.
Lord, make us an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us know love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt,
faith.
Where there is despair,
hope.
Where there is darkness,
light.
And where there is sadness,
joy.
O Divine Master, grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled,
as
to be understood,
as to
be loved,
as to love.
For it is giving
that we receive.
It is in pardoning
that we are pardoned.
And it is in dying
that we are born to eternal life.
Amen.
Christ invites to his table all who long for grace, all who need mercy, all who desire a new beginning. Christ invites to his table you and me. Therefore, let us confess our sin to Almighty God. We're going to pause for a moment of silent prayer for your silent confession, and then I will conclude with a prayer of confession. Let us pray. Gracious God, we are not what we should be. But by your grace and mercy, your strength, we become all that you've created us to be. Forgive us, we pray. Turn our hearts toward you, that we may reflect the beauty of your peace, the wonder of your love, the truth of your spirit. Through Christ our Lord, we pray.
Amen.
We come to Christ's table today thankful to God. Lord, what a beautiful day you have made for us. What a beautiful church you have placed us in. And sometimes, Lord, we just don't have the words for all that you have done for us. And so we will just lift up an alleluia and an amen. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Amen.
We come to Christ's table today thankful for Jesus Christ, God's love and mercy in the flesh, the one who came to this world to show us how to live, to die for us, and then to rise again, promising that one day we will too. But until then, we can continue to live as his people here, Easter people. And so whenever we come to this table, we remember that Christ was at a table with his disciples, whom he called friends. And he took bread. And he gave thanks to God, and then he broke the bread. And he gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Take, eat. This is my body, broken and given for you. Whenever you do this in remembrance of me." And then he took the cup, and he gave thanks to you, God, and he gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. And whenever you drink this, do this in remembrance of me." And so in remembrance, Lord, of these your mighty acts and so much more through Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves as a holy and living sacrifice. We offer ourselves as a living alleluia, as a living amen, so that the world will know the light of Christ. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Amen.
We come to this table today thankful for God's Holy Spirit, that is God's presence with us wherever we are, especially on this beautiful day during this wonderful service of confirmation and communion. And so we pray that that Holy Spirit continue to make these into Christ's body and into Christ's blood, and then to make us into the body of Christ, so that we might be for the world the body of Christ redeemed by his blood, so that we might be for the world a living alleluia and a living amen. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Amen.
Amen.
Please join me in the prayer that our Lord has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I'd like to invite our servers to please come forward.
Who's going to have the bread?
choir, please come and partake. And at the direction of the ushers, we'll invite you to come and partake of the elements. Thank you. If you would like to know more about what it means to be a member of St. Andrew-by-the-Sea United Methodist Church, please speak with me or with Pastor Frank or with our 18 newest members. After this service, we would love to point you to some more discipleship opportunities here at St. Andrew-by-the-Sea. Just remember that immediately following this in our Celebration Center is a free celebration lunch honoring our confirmands, our newest members, and all are invited to attend. We hope to see you there. I want to invite you now to stand as you are able. Let's join our voices together in our hymn of sending, We Are the Church. All right, for our benediction, we are going to do our confirmation youth benediction. We closed every confirmation session. We close every youth gathering with the same benediction. All right, y'all, get a little closer. We got to lock our arms, okay? Lock our arms. Pastor Frank are going to lock our arms over the air. All right. We call this the United Methodist Youth Benediction. It's also in the book of Numbers, also the blessing of Aaron. Please say it along with us if you know it. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. Amen. Friends, go in peace. New members, if you would please make your way out there towards Miss Connie. Let's take you on over to the Celebration Center so that we can enjoy our lunch together.